friends, welcome to wifistudy.com, one-stop destination for all competitive exams. My name is Bhunesh Sharma, and friends, today in this topic, in this video, we are going to present you the another topic of static GK, that is Banking in India, PSB, with their headquarters in English. In our previous video, we made this video in Hindi, and right now we are going to present you this topic in English. Friends, if you want to prepare from the application mode, you can download our Wi-Fi study app. This is a very useful and handy app in which you will get a daily current affairs, GK test, and many more questions related to the reasoning, mathematics, GK, and you can download this app from the Google Play. So friends, slowly and slowly we covered all the topics of static GK in both the formats, that is in Hindi and English. And today we are going to present you this last topic of static GK in English. So let's start from the banking in India. First of all, I will tell you about the what is a bank. Okay, we are going to study the banking in India, banking structure in India, PSB, public sector bank, their headquarters in India, which is the foremost important question for your IBPS or bank exam. Okay, there are the majorly possibility of the bank questions from this topic is of headquarters. Okay, and I will tell you the most easy trick to remember bank headquarters, and this is very common trick and very easy and very helpful to learn the headquarters of public sector banks. Okay, so before going to that, we will cover some important thing, important terms and important data about the banking in India. Okay, firstly, we will study what is a bank, its structure, then some another important bank like SIDBI, Exim Bank. Okay, then after that, we'll go to the PSB. So first of all, what is a bank? A bank is a financial organization which accept deposits that can be withdrawn on demand and also lend money to individuals and business houses that need it. It is a financial organization. Look friends, it is a financial organization which accept deposit that can be withdrawn on demand, and they can also lend money to individuals and the business houses that need it. Okay, so it is a bank which is a financial organization that accept deposit that give money to the individual and the business houses. The first bank in India is the Bank of Hindustan. It was started in 1770, established at the Calcutta under European management. Okay, so this is your first question. Which is the first bank of India? First bank in India. So Bank of Hindustan is the first bank in India in 1770, established at the Calcutta under European management. So friends, this is the structure of the banking sector in India. This is very important and you need to understand the structure of the banking sector. If you are giving a paper of the IBPS or a bank exam, then you need to understand the structure of the banking system. Firstly, there is a finance ministry. There are different ministries of India like defense, Ministry of Defense, Ministry of Telecommunication, Ministry of Sports, as there is a one Ministry of Finance. The chairperson, the finance minister right now is the Arun Jaitley. He is the head of the Ministry of Finance. Or there is a under the Ministry of Finance, there is a RBI. The chairperson of the RBI, the governor of the RBI right now is the Arjit Patel. Arjit Patel is the governor of RBI. He is the 24th governor. Okay, previously he was working as a deputy governor since 2013. Okay, so RBI was established on 1st April 1935. 1st April 1935 RBI was established. Okay, they published monetary policy, and the head of the monetary policy previously was Ajit Patel, was the head of the monetary policy before becoming the governor of the RBI. Okay, so under the RBI there is a scheduled bank. Under the RBI there is a scheduled bank. Okay, there are two types of banks, scheduled bank and there is a non-scheduled bank. We are not going to study about the non-scheduled banks because they are not important for the exam. Okay, and they are not mentioned in the second schedule of the RBI Act. Those banks which are mentioned in the second schedule, okay, second schedule of the RBI Act 1934 are known as scheduled bank. Okay, those banks which are under the second schedule of the RBI Act 1934 are known as the scheduled bank. There are two types of scheduled bank. First is a commercial bank, second is a cooperative bank. First is a commercial bank, second is the cooperative banks. You can be, You can enlarge this one also. This is a cooperative bank. Okay. So first is a commercial bank and second is a cooperative bank. Under the commercial bank, there are four banks. First, the PSB, that is public sector bank. For example, like PNB, SBI, okay, and other banks. And second is a private sector bank like ICCI, ICCI, HDFC, Axis Bank. All these are banks are the private sector bank. Third is the foreign bank, that is the HSBC, Citibank, and another is the regional rural bank, that is RRB. Okay, first RRB, regional rural bank, is the Prathama Bank in UP. It was opened in UP. Okay, there are a lot more RRBs like Marudhara Rajasthan Grameen Bank, Kerala Grameen Bank, Manipur Rural Bank. So all these banks like PSB, private sector bank, foreign bank, regional rural bank are all commercial banks. Okay, so there is another one, that is cooperative bank. Under the cooperative bank, there are two banks, that is urban cooperative and state cooperative. Under cooperative, urban cooperative and state cooperative banks. Firstly, what is a cooperative bank? Okay, the first cooperative bank was opened in Vadodara in Gujarat. Okay, the name of that bank was Anonya Cooperative Bank. Anonya Cooperative Bank was the first cooperative bank which was opened in Vadodara in Gujarat. And they works on no profit, no loss basis. Cooperative bank was made for those person who don't want to give large percentage of interest to the zamindars and the land owners. Okay, so cooperative bank is made on the basis of no profit, no loss sharing. If a majority of the people with the common sharing open a bank with a cooperative bank and they want to give like 1,000 rupees per month and there are 100 people, so there is a collection of 1 lakh rupees. So if there is a one person who want 1 lakh rupees, so he can withdraw that amount. Okay, and the rest of the year he will give that amount whichever he took it. So this is the meaning of the cooperative bank. Corporation. Okay, you are in the corporation. You are working with a corporation. You are working in a cooperative manner. That is the work of the corporation bank. Okay, cooperative banks. So there is one urban cooperative and there is a state cooperative. State cooperative are opened by state. For example, Rajasthan State Cooperative Bank, Meghalaya State Cooperative Bank. Okay, these are the example of state cooperative. Okay, so this is the structure of the banking sector in India. Minister of Finance, under it, there is one RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India is known as the Central Bank of India. Okay, he is a bank of the bank. Like India, we have a central bank like RBI. US has the central bank named Federal Reserve. Okay, Federal Reserve is the central bank of USA. And the Bank of England is the central bank of UK. As we have RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Okay, under it there is a scheduled bank. Scheduled bank are of two types, commercial and cooperative banks. Commercial are of four types, PSB, private sector, foreign bank and RRBs. And cooperative banks are of two types, that is urban bank and state cooperative bank. So let's study about some more banks which are frequently in the news. Okay, first is NABARD. NABARD, what is the NABARD bank? NABARD, the full form of the NABARD is the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. It is established in 1982. It provides the rural credit to the farmers and it is the apex institution for rural credit. Okay, it provides the rural credit to the farmers. As its name suggests, it is a bank for agriculture and the rural development. Okay, they give loan to the farmers, to the small scale industries for the development of the rural, not industries, to the small great persons. Okay, for the rural development. Okay, so it is a NABARD bank, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. Another is a SIDBI. So it is a bank which gives loan to the small industries. Okay, the full form of the SIDBI is a Small Industries Development Bank of India. Give credits to the small industries. As its name suggests, Small Industries Development. Okay, it gives loan to the small industries for development of their business. Another is the Exchange Bank. These banks are engaged in buying and selling foreign exchange. These banks help the growth of international trade. Okay, these banks are engaged in buying and selling foreign exchange. They deal in a foreign exchange. Okay, and they promote the growth of international trade. So these are the banks known as Exchange Bank. Another is the Exim Bank. The full form of the Exim is export and import. This is X is the export, this is import. Okay, known as the export import bank. Such bank provide long term financial assistance to the exporter and importers, established in 1982, and its headquarters is in Mumbai. Okay, this is important bank because this bank is in frequently news because of the export import. Okay, and its headquarters is in Mumbai. And there are few more points that you need to remember for the exam. That is, SBI is the oldest bank of India. Okay, which is the oldest bank of India? SBI is the oldest bank of India. The oldest public sector bank of India, having branches all over India and serving the customers for last 145 years, is the Allahabad Bank. Okay, so oldest public sector bank of India is Allahabad Bank. And Allahabad Bank is also known as the one of the India's oldest stock bank. However, oldest stock bank of India was Bank of Upper India, established in 1863, failed in 1913. Okay, however, oldest stock bank of India was Bank of Upper India, established in 1863, failed in 1913. The first bank purely managed by India was PNB. Okay, this is another important question. The first bank purely managed by India was PNB, Punjab National Bank, established in Lahore in 1895. The first Indian commercial bank, which was wholly owned and managed by Indian, was Central Bank of India. Okay, this was established in 1911. So Central Bank of India is known as the India first truly Swadeshi bank. So this is another important question, which is the first truly Swadeshi bank. So Central Bank of India is the first in truly Swadeshi bank, because this bank is managed by the Indians, owned by the Indians, and it is the India's first commercial bank. India first commercial bank, which is managed and owned by Indian. Okay, and the first bank purely managed by India was Punjab National Bank. The first bank of India with limited liabilities, with the limited responsibilities to be managed by the Indian board was Oud Commercial Bank. It was established in 1881 at Faizabad, but failed in 1958. Okay, the first bank with limited liability was Oud Commercial Bank. It was established in 1881. So these are the few more information that was important for you, and you need to remember this also. So now we are going towards the public sector bank and their headquarters. Okay, firstly we need to understand what is a public sector bank. Okay, after that I will tell you the tricks to remember the headquarters of the public sector bank, which is very common and very handy. So which was the public sector bank? Who are the public sector bank in India? This is the first question that you need to remember and you need to understand. So PSB, that is the public sector bank, are the bank with a majority stake, that is the more than 50%, is held by a government. The share of these banks are listed on the stock exchange, okay, like National Stock Exchange and the Bombay Stock Exchange. Okay, and there are total of 27 PSB in India. Right now there are 27 PSBs, 19 nationalized bank plus 6 state bank. Okay, in state bank groups there is a 1 SBI bank plus 5 associates. Okay, so total of 6 state bank groups. And the rest of the two, that is the IDBI and the Bharatiya Mahila Bank, which was categorized as other public sector bank. So these are the two banks which came into the PSB in 2011. Okay, these are the two banks. So there are 27 PSBs, 19 are the nationalized bank, plus 6 state bank group, plus 2, that is IDBI and the Bharatiya Mahila Bank. Okay, so these are the 27 PSBs. So firstly, let's see the history of the PSBs. Okay, what is the aim to make the PSBs or to nationalize the banks? Okay, all these things. The central government entered the banking business with the nationalization of the Imperial Bank of India. Okay, so Imperial Bank of India. Previously, there was few bank, that is the Presidency Bank. There was 3 bank known as the Presidency Bank. Okay, the name of the 3 Presidency Bank was Bank of Bombay, Bank of Calcutta and Bank of Madras. So these are the 3 banks which was known as the Presidency Bank. So in 1921, all these 3 banks merged into one single bank known as the Imperial Bank of India. Okay, 1921, all these 3 banks merged into a single bank known as Imperial Bank of India. Okay, in 1955, government came into the banking business and changed its name That no, and the name they put is SBI. That is the central, that is the State Bank of India. In 1955, the Imperial Bank of India became the State Bank of India. Okay, and this is the oldest bank of India. Okay, so 60, they took 60% stake was taken by RBI, and the new bank was named as SBI. After that, seven other banks became the subsidiaries of the new bank. In 1969, government added 14 major banks also, and there was another round of nationalization that took place in 1980. First, Narasimhan Committee gave bill gave blueprint of banking sector reforms. Okay, so first was the Narasimhan Committee gave blueprint of the banking sector reforms. This is another question: who gave the blueprint of the banking sector reforms? So Narasimhan Committee was a committee which gave the blueprint of banking sector reforms. So what is the objective behind nationalization? Okay, so objective behind nationalization are to break the ownership and control of bank by a few business families. Okay, the government want to break the ownership and the control of banks by a few business families to prevent the concentration of the wealth and the economic power. Because of the few business families, the majority of the money will be with the hand of the with the millionaires only. Okay, so government want to prevent the concentration of wealth with the few people. Okay, they want to distribute the money, okay, to the lower section of the society also, to mobilize saving from masses from all part of the country. Okay, if there is a public sector bank, they will definitely provide a saving mean of a there is mean of a saving to the masses, okay, to the other parts of the country also, other part of the people also, to cater to the needs to the priority sector, and they want to cater to the needs of the priority sector also. So these are the objective behind nationalization. Okay, so now let's start to learn the headquarters of the PSBs. So first trick is to all the banks that have India at the end of their name have their headquarters in Mumbai, except United Bank of India. Every bank except United Bank of India, which have India at the end of their name, okay, they all have their headquarters in Mumbai. For example, SBI, State Bank of India, its headquarters is in Mumbai. Second, Bank of India, its headquarters is in Mumbai. Central Bank of India, Mumbai. Union Bank of India, Mumbai. Reserve Bank of India, Mumbai. IDBI, that is Industrial Development Bank of India, Mumbai. State and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, that is Mumbai. And there's another one, that is Dena Bank. Okay, so Dena Bank and the United Bank, these are the two banks that you need to take care. And their headquarter, Dena Bank headquarter is also in Mumbai. In spite of that, this bank don't have a India at their end. Okay, even though Dena Bank have a headquarter in Mumbai, apart from it, United Bank of India. You need to remember that United Bank of India headquarter is not in Mumbai. It is in Kolkata. United Bank of India, its headquarter is in Kolkata. Okay, so another trick is in Delhi, Punjabi girls excel in commerce. You need to remember this single sentence that in Delhi, Punjabi girls excel in commerce. This is a mnemonic to remember which bank have headquarter in Delhi. Okay, so Punjabi girls excel in commerce. So by learning this only, this mnemonic, you will be able to understand, you will be able to remember four bank headquarters easily. First, the Punjabi girls excel in commerce, that is Punjabi, that is Punjab National Bank, Punjab and Sind Bank. Okay, girls, that is Bharatiya Mahila Bank, and commerce, that is Oriental Bank of Commerce. Okay, all these four banks have their headquarter in Delhi. Okay, so you need to remember only one sentence, that is in Delhi, Punjabi girls excel in commerce. Punjabi, you will get two banks, that is Punjab National Bank, Punjab and Sind Bank, Oriental Bank of Commerce, and the Bharatiya Mahila Bank. Okay, these are the four banks that you will easily remember by learning a single sentence, that is in Delhi, Punjabi girls excel in commerce. Another trick is all banks starting with Indian have their headquarter in Chennai. Okay, for example, Indian Bank and Indian Overseas Bank. Okay, any bank which have a name in the starting, that is Indian, its headquarter will be in Chennai. Like Indian Bank, and second is the Indian Overseas Bank, both have headquarter in Chennai. So another is the bank that starts with U, have their headquarters in Kolkata. Okay. Have their headquarters in Kolkata. Any bank which starts with the U, except one bank, that is Union Bank of India. It's headquartered in Mumbai. Okay, except Union Bank of India. Its headquarters is in Mumbai. Apart from it, there are two few banks which are in Kolkata, that is UCO Bank. It starts with the U, so its headquarters is in Kolkata. Another is the United Bank of India. As I told you previously also, the United Bank of India headquarters is in Kolkata. Apart from it, you also need to remember Allahabad Bank. Allahabad Bank headquarters is also in Kolkata. Okay, as Dena Bank has have a headquarters in Mumbai, as Allahabad Bank have a headquarters in Kolkata. Okay, so Union Bank of India, Mumbai, as I told you before also. And there is another mnemonic that you need to remember apart from one Delhi mnemonic, that is Vijay Can Bank. If you remember this line, Vijay Can Bank, okay, Vijay Dinanath Chauhan, you can remember this Agnipath, the famous Agnipath character, okay, Vijay Can Bank. So from the Vijay, you will get the Vijaya Bank, and from the Can, you will get a Canara Bank, and Bank is the Bangalore. So Vijaya Bank and the Canara Bank have their headquarters in Bangalore, that is Canara Bank and Vijaya Bank. Okay, so these are the few, this is the few tricks that you need to remember. First is the all the banks which have a India at their last have their headquarters in Mumbai, except United Bank of India, except United Bank of India. Okay, second is the all banks which start with the Indian have their headquarters in Chennai. All banks start with U, headquarters is in Kolkata. And the two mnemonics, first is the in Delhi, Punjabi girls excel in commerce. Punjabi girls excel in commerce. From the Punjabi, that is Punjab National Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank, both have headquarters in Delhi. Girls, Bharatiya Mahila Bank, its headquarters is in Delhi. And the Oriental Bank of Commerce headquarters is also in New Delhi. And the last one is the Vijay Can Bank. From the Vijay, it is the Vijaya Bank. From the Can, it is the Canara Bank. Both have headquarters in Bangalore. Okay, so this is the five trees that you need to remember. Okay, and there are a few banks also which are self-explanatory. You don't need to remember their headquarters. Their headquarters will come into their name itself. Okay, for example, Bank of Baroda, its headquarters is Baroda, that is Vadodara. Okay, Bank of Maharashtra, there is one city of Maharashtra, that is Pune, so its headquarters is in Pune. Andhra Bank, its headquarters is in Hyderabad. Then State Bank of Patiala, its headquarters is in Patiala. State Bank of Hyderabad, its headquarters is in Hyderabad. Okay, another one, that is Andhra Bank headquarters is also in Hyderabad. Okay, Andhra Bank and State Bank of Hyderabad. Then State Bank of Travancore, its headquarters is in Thiruvananthapuram. Then State Bank of Mysore, its headquarters is in Bangalore. Okay, both cities are in Karnataka. And another is the SBBJ, that is State Bank of Bikaner and Jaipur. Its headquarters is in Jaipur. So these are the few self-explanatory banks headquarters that you need to understand. And the last two banks which don't have any trick and you need to remember, it's the Syndicate Bank and the Corporation Bank. Syndicate Bank have headquarters in Manipal, has a headquarters in Manipal. Syndicate Bank has a headquarters in Manipal. And Corporation Bank has a headquarters in Mangalore. Okay, there is one city Bangalore and there is another city Mangalore. So Syndicate Bank has a headquarters in Manipal, and Corporation Bank has a headquarters in Mangalore. Okay, so these are the all PSBs, 27 PSBs, and that you need to remember, okay, about their headquarters. So friends, hope you like this video, and if you like this video, please subscribe us so that we can provide you more videos, more content, and will help you in your upcoming exam. So friends, thank you and all the best for your exam.